Hi everyone, my name is Alissa Brown, and in this video I'm going to discuss some of the results of our recent work that focus on tree recruitment patterns in temperate forests. We know that trees make seeds that eventually leave the adult tree and, ideally, land on the ground in some nice soil. For a lot of species, we expect there to be a higher density of seedlings growing near the adult tree where those seeds fell, and sometimes this is true. But there is another pattern we often see in forests, and that is of seedling avoidance of trees of the same species. Conspecific is the term we use for individuals of the same species. In these situations, we think that higher densities of plant enemies exist near adult trees, making it harder for conspecific seedlings to survive. Plant enemies might be soil pathogens that infect roots or herbivores that eat leaves. The term we use for this process is conspecific negative density or distance dependence, abbreviated as CNDD. The reason CNDD is important is that it's thought to be a natural mechanism that maintains high tree diversity. Ecologists have been studying this process since the late 1960s, when Daniel Janzen and JanzenConnell independently published their observations of this phenomenon. Thus, you may also hear this process called the JanzenConnell effect. Now, not all tree species show evidence of CNDD, and it's not clear in what situations and for what species this process occurs. One approach ecologists have started to take to understand this is by using plant traits as a way to predict which species are more susceptible to CNDD. Plant traits are really just characteristics of plants, such as average height, leaf thickness, or wood density. For predicting susceptibility to CNDD, we think about plant traits that are correlated with tissue defense, because the way in which trees defend their tissues against pathogen infection or herbivory may say something about whether their seedlings can withstand attacks from these plant enemies. One such plant trait is shade tolerance, indicating whether a tree can survive in the shade under low light conditions. Species able to withstand living in the shade may send a greater proportion of their energy resources to defending their tissues rather than to growing fast. This is a strategy that makes sense when you want to wait it out in the shade for a few years until a canopy gap opens up and you can grow in those higher light conditions. Another plant trait we might use to predict susceptibility to CNDD is one that indicates which type of mutualistic fungus you typically have living on your roots. These mycorrhizal fungi are found on all trees, and there are two primary types, ectomycorrhizal and arbuscular mycorrhizal. Ectomycorrhizal fungi are thought to better protect tree roots from soil pathogen infection by forming a thick barrier of fungal hyphae around the root tips. So how do we measure CNDD? We can determine whether CNDD is occurring by measuring distances between young trees and adult trees. We can also survey a forest plot over time and see whether the growth rate or survival of young trees is related to the density of conspecific adults near them. So after doing this, what did we find? Do these two plant traits, shade tolerance and mycorrhizal type, help us predict which species are susceptible to CNDD? The answer to this question is a very common observation in ecology, and that is, well, it depends. Depends on how you measure CNDD, whether it's by spatial separation of stems, growth rates, or survival. It also probably depends on the age of the young stem. The youngest stems, called seedlings, are more likely to respond to enemies through mortality. The older stems, called saplings, are more likely to respond to enemies through reduction in growth rate. But what about plant traits? We found that species with high shade tolerance that can withstand shaded conditions are more likely to survive with a lot of conspecifics nearby when they're seedlings, and then exhibit lower growth rates when they grow older. The reduced growth rate may be a strategy for spending a lot of resources on tissue defense rather than growth to make sure they can survive with high densities of enemies surrounding them. In terms of mycorrhizal type, we found that when there's a high density of conspecifics nearby, seedlings don't respond differently to the two different mycorrhizal types, But saplings associated with ectomycorrhizae show higher growth rates than those associating with arbuscular mycorrhizae under the same conditions. It's important to acknowledge that our results come from six forest plots within a small geographic range in the Piedmont of North Carolina. While our work supports much of the previous work that's been done in this field of study, we may be seeing some location-specific results. With that in mind, in conclusion, we found that this diversity-maintaining process, CNDD, acts differently depending on the characteristics and age of the tree, as seedlings having high shade tolerance may reduce effects of CNDD, as seedlings grow to be saplings, having high shade tolerance may reduce your growth to ensure survival, and associating with ectomycorrhizae as a sapling may reduce the effects of CNDD.